Adventure games. As I have told before, it used to be my favorite genre. I promised myself that I'm going to play more adventure games, and after I played The Uncertain Light at the End, I remembered why I love that genre. But what adventure game would be next? Click and point one? Puzzle one? Neither. I decided to play 2D pixely art dialogue-driven adventure game for the first time in my life, and oh boy, it paid off. The game is called Lacuna, and it is developed by Digitales, an indie game studio from Germany. To be more precise, and I apologize my pronouncement, from Saarbrücken. Lacuna was released on Steam in May, and it was very well received, as you can see here. It's also Digitales' debut game, and what a game it is. As a person who hasn't played a lot, well, any pixel art games, first impression for me was beautiful but messy art style. And before you judge me, no, it's not messy, it just seemed like it, first because I have no experience of pixel art games. But after 15 minutes I was loving the art style and everything became clearer and easier to follow. Actually, the game is very atmospheric and it's got the future sci-fi mood going on. You know, long trench coats, robots, flying cars, neotech vibes and all that cool Blade Runner kind of stuff. Also, because the game is 2D, it's really easy to control and you won't get lost. Well, I did, but I am a simple person. At first, when you open the PDA, which is basically your data inventory, it might be a bit overwhelming. There are like a million different tabs and things to click. Clues, sheets, emails, conversations, and so on. But you get used to it pretty fast, and eventually it's easy to use. Well, as a 2D side-scrolling adventure game, the main mechanics and controls are pretty simple. Most of your time goes walking around different areas, having conversations, and smoking cigarettes. Yes, you heard me. Unlike most adventure games, Lacuna handles puzzles a bit differently. There are no items. There are actually cases you must solve, which is fitting because you play as a detective, and all the cases are tied to game's narrative. You get these sheets, and based on your conclusions, you need to make right decisions before you submit them to your superiors. How to make right decision? By investigating areas and hotspots, talking with people, and actually by using your own brains and piecing things together. Investigation has its own mode. By pressing button, so-called investigation bubble appears. While in that mode, it highlights points of interest related to case and things you can interact. It works very well. If or when you make wrong conclusion, what happens then? Does it affect your gameplay experience? Honestly, I don't know, but I think it affects the ending you'll get. While talking to suspects and other people, you have multiple answer options, and sometimes you have to make quick decisions because there is timer. Giving options is nice touch, because pretty much everything else in the game is quite linear. It wasn't a problem for me, but it might frustrate some. First things first, this is going to be a spoiler-free description, so no worries. The game is set on the planet Gara, an Earth-like world. You play as Neil Conrad, a detective working for the CDI, which is law enforcement thing investigating bigger crimes, so no shoplistings or beer thefts. Neil is very stereotypic protagonist in sci-fi universe. Long trench coat, ex-wife, lives alone, smokes cigarettes, and all the other stuff you could expect. Game starts when Neil receives his next assignment, which is murder of Drovia's foreign minister. Drovia is a Garian colony struggling for the independence. Obviously, things are never that simple, and before you know it, you are neck deep in poo, with all the conspiracies, terrorists, missing persons, political tensions, twists and turns. The story kept me intrigued all its playtime, which was about 5 hours. Lacuna is a pretty short game, thankfully, because there is a ton of replay value. You can make wrong decisions, ignore important side quests, give wrong descriptions, and ask wrong questions, and all these may affect your gameplay experience. I completed it only once, so I don't have exact information about it, but trust me on this one. As I mentioned earlier, I loved the art style in Lacuna. It took me a while, but when it hit hard. Backgrounds are full of movement, neon lights, traffic, and other details that make the world feel bigger than it actually is. After a while, you can even spot the difference between characters and recognize them. But nothing builds a mood more than music, and it delivers. It fits the atmosphere perfectly. Usually, the music is kind of smooth, relaxing sci-fi, noir, jazz, piano play. But occasionally, in tough spots, it transforms into dramatic and tense music that keeps you on your toes. There are no voice acting, except random Neil's monologues when he wraps up Day's thoughts while making his way back to apartment.
I looked at my reflection in the glass and down at the layers of city below my feet. I'd almost told Kat how strange being in our old place still felt to me. I didn't want her to think I still missed her. Maybe I did, because something still hurt when I saw her. Although it might just have been the memory of not getting something we wanted, of having failed. As good as we may be at making sense of things, there are some we can't work into the narrative.
Like the uncertain light at the end, this was a real gem. I enjoyed the game my whole playtime and can recommend this to anyone who likes detective stories or adventure games. With gorgeous art style, moody music, compelling storyline, interesting and thoughtful puzzles, replay value, and a price tag of 13 euros, it is a great investment. If you fancy to try Lacuna but are uncertain to spend your money, there is free prologue to download in Steam. Oh, and by the way, if you thought you can make decisions in the game and see the outcome, then just load a previous save if you're not happy about it. That's not gonna work, because game uses an autosave feature. So only way to make different choices is to start again from scratch. Luckily, it is a pleasure.